السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته نحمده ونصلي على رسوله الكريم أما بعد آج کا سبق سن لیجئے.
Let us listen to the آج کا سبق which is delivered daily by Hazrat Morana Muhammad Yunus the son of Hazrat Morana Muhammad Umar Palanpuri rahmatullahi alayh. Lesson number 875. In this lesson we learn one thing, that in the journey of Mi'raj there were three separate instances whereby Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used three different means of transport. The one was when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam went from Masjid al-Haram in Mecca to Masjid al-Aqsa with the Buraq. After that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam traveled from Masjid al-Aqsa till Sidratul Muntaha, the seventh heaven, the uppermost heaven. On that, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam climbed a set of stairs. And from there, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, from Sidratul Muntaha, on stairs made of pearls, was taken from there to beyond that aspect of Sidratul Muntaha. This is something, this which we make mention of, you will not find it in one particular hadith. Rather, the different ahadith with regards to the mi'raj of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, it was taken in a synopsis of the entire thing is presented before you. Let us try and appreciate this particular aspect. When Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam completed the salah, and with Jibreel alayhi salam they sat on the dastarkhan, thereafter four different big huge bowls were placed in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. The one was that of milk. The second was that of honey. The third was that of water. And the fourth was that of wine. So obviously now all of them are guests that are there. So they have to present something to the guest. So when they put everything, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam turned to Jibreel and said, "What is this?" So Jibreel alayhi salam replied, "This is milk." Thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam asked, "What is this?" Jibreel alayhi salam said, "This is honey." And it went forward. So thereafter Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam said Bismillah, and he drank to his heart's content whatever milk Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam could drink. And from the honey also Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam consumed a little bit from there. Those two bowls that had water and alcohol and wine, Nabi sallallahu alayhi wasallam never gave any concentration towards it. Jibreel alayhi salam said that you have chosen the natural deen. Had you chosen wine, your ummah and your followers would have went astray because of that. And had you chosen water, then your ummah would have been drowned and would have been destroyed in this. And like this, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protected and saved Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. From there, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam from Masjid al-Aqsa to the first heaven. The same means which by the souls travel to the heaven, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the heaven. And as they reached the first door, in there Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came to the first door at the first sky, which is known as Babul Hifz. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went with Jibreel alayhi salam to that door. While on this journey, there was angels that had surrounded Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and they were moving with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. On the way, there was a devil that was troubling Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This was known as Ifrit. So then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told Jibreel alayhi salam with regards to this, because he was perturbed by the way this Ifrit was behaving with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So thereafter, between the heavens and the earth, between the earth and the sky, Jibreel alayhi salam told Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to read a particular dua. This dua is also made mention of in the Kitab of Morana, where he makes mention of the morning and the evening duas. And in this year also, At a later stage, we will also make mention of this dua. So this is the story of the incident of Mi'raj and one portion of it. Inshallah, as we go along, this will carry on and we will try and complete the incident of Mi'raj. Now let us read, حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. حسبنا الله ونعم الوكيل. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept from us. Ameen, ameen. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.